students to give a standing ovation to our chief guest and rank holders, all the rank holders.
Thank you, sir, for the wonderful analogy on Pepsi. I now call upon Sushmita to introduce the rank holders.
Thank you, Lakshmi. The way you do one thing describes the way you do everything. And I think this people's way will show you a way ahead to get easier success. And our first rank holder, Shobha Suresh, completed her articleship in Deloitte. Audit division secured AIR 8 in CA final and AIR 22 in the IPCE examination. She received her BCom honors degree with distinction from Sri Venkateshwara College. Please put your hands together and welcome CA Shobha Suresh. Our next rank holder, CA Ami Mehta, a consistent ace performer who secured topper in SSLC, backed the class topper at Christ University, has secured CPT topper in Bangalore, All India rank 41 in IPCC, and All India rank 47 in final. All of this in her first attempt. She has also bagged several awards to her name, recognized as Employee Who Takes Initiative. Received Kudos Award at KPMG for statutory audit of AstraZeneca Pharma India Limited and several other recognitions. She has also participated in several CSR events like Khelo Rugby and various CSR events. She is also an athlete, secured first, second positions in 400 meters, 800 meters, high jump, annual road run, in annual athletic meet. She is currently working at DSR Affiliates KPMG. Let's join together and give a warm welcome to CA Ami. Our next rank holder, CA Annapurna Shrika, a nominated member in FKCCI GST Committee. She is an empaneled member in the Faculty of Indirect Taxes Committee of ICAI. She has made presentations at professional forums and before the corporate, business community and general public on taxation audits, use of technology and GST. Achieving All India third rank in CA, CS and Diploma in Information Technology. A chartered accountant in Mysuru, practicing since 2008, handling direct and indirect taxation audits, consultation litigation. She has bagged several awards like Excellence Award by Vasavi Union Bengaluru, Pragna Award, Women of Excellence Award. She also has been awarded with the Best Speaker title for Oratory Skills in a Leadership and Personality Development Program titled Born to Excel of Human Relations Institute Clinics. Please put your hands together and welcome CA Annapurna Shrika. Now I'd like to call upon Mr. Veerendra for introducing other rank holders. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Our next rank holder is CA Priya K, a chartered accountant by profession who has passed IPCCA final with 11th and 46th rank respectively. A teacher by passion, she believes that victory loves preparation and when preparation becomes a habit, victory too becomes a habit. A finance professional with an inclination towards constant learning and development, she started her career by joining a startup. A chartered accountant, she is also a diploma holder of International Finance Reporting Standards from ACCA UK and has completed CFA Level 1 with 90% marks. She has been actively involved in helping more than 1,000 students to achieve their dreams of becoming a financial professional by taking up teaching and conducting motivation sessions. Let's join together and give a warm welcome to CA Priya K. Our next rank holder, CA Balakrishna Silveri, secured All India 47th rank in CA final, has completed BCom from SV University. Coming from a humble background, he completed his articleship from Sundar Srini and Sridhar Chartered Accountants. Let's join together and give a warm welcome, CA Balakrishna Silveri. And our next rank holder, CA Atul Agarwal, All India topper in CA final, has worked in Infosys for IFRS, implementation UC SAP and calculation of deferred tax for the company, presented cost analysis and utilization of warehousing to the management and helped the management to reduce the cost of warehousing by 12 lakhs per annum. Then currently pursuing CS and holds a certification in IFRS with a view to give back to the society. He participated in school kit distribution done by Samarpan. Let's join together and give a warm welcome to CA Atul Agarwal.
Our next rank holder, Aradhana Upadhyay, a person who is a singer and loves watching comedy shows. She has secured 4th rank in graduation from Bangalore University. She is currently doing her articleship at Silu and Associates. She has secured All India rank 27 in IPCC. Please put your hands together and welcome Aradhana Upadhyay. Our next rank holder, Deepak Acharya, has secured All India rank 36 in IPCC. An ambitious and a determined individual aspiring to become a chartered accountant by the age of 21. He comes from a family background where no one has taken up this challenging course and will be the first chartered accountant in the family tree. An all-rounder whose hobbies range from sports to logical puzzles and sketching. Currently pursuing BCom, Finance and Accountancy from Christ University, Bangalore, and is about to join articleship at Deloitte. Please put your hands together and welcome Deepak Acharya.
Our next rank holder is Prabha V, a violent player and a Carnatic music singer, a consistent top achiever, secured 7th rank for the state and stood first for Mount Carmel PU College in Karnataka pre-university examination held in the year 2016. Secured All India 43rd rank in CAICCC exam in November 2017. Currently pursuing 2nd year BCom in St. Joseph College of Commerce and articleship in KP Rao & Co. Let's join together and give you a warm welcome of Prabha V. Our next rank holder is Kamal M. Dogia. He's a guitarist as well as vocalist aspiring to become a musician. Apart from studies, he is a current music production and he is one of the top 20 singers of Bangalore in the Bollywood Music Project. He also secured 3rd rank in ISC at Joseph and had a record of scoring 100 in economics and scorer of All India 50th rank in IPCC in November 2017. Please put your hands together and welcome Kamal and Dorisha.
Thank you, Sushmita, Mamsi and Mirendra, and welcome all the rank holders. At this junction, we would like you to take a small tea break. The tea is served on the canopy. And before you leave, ensure you write your names on the dais, names and your contact details right there. Okay? Thank you, guys. before, because we have to divide you into 10 groups, the entire audience, so that we can have 10 rank holders placed for each. Currently the groups are imbalanced because there is no one there and all that. So in order to arrange you, I want you to start counting your numbers. Yeah, you can start.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
No, no, continue from 11.
14.
Yes, start.
17, 18, 19, 20.
Remember your numbers, guys.
21, 22, 23, 25, 26, 27.
One second, you start. 29. They also 28.
36, 36. I request final year students preferably go to a final rank holder. IPC students go preferably to it. IPC rank holder, better for interaction. Otherwise, no issues, we can say.
Structuring the discussion.
As I told you, you can write down your whatever queries you have, whatever you want to ask. One by one, you can ask.
See you. Balakrishna Chille.
Which is my team?
Lakshmi.
Yeah, she's here. Yeah?
Oh, you go to the last one. See, Atul Agarwal, sir, you. Aradhana Upadhyay. Deepak Acharya, that group. About me, Kamal is the last one. Guys, you can ask Kamal to sing, please. I hope all of you have been assigned to your particular groups. Please make yourself comfortable. Start interacting with the rank holders. And all the best, guys. Have a good interactive session.
Just one announcement. How many of the groups have been made? And there's a suggestion. You guys can interact. Discuss about all the possible attributes, all the possible guiding factors that your respective guide and mentor can give to you, and also identify what are the top three important things that are necessary to help you pass the examination. Each group, identify the top three that you guys come to a consensus as to what should be the best trait that you should have to qualify the exams, and then all the groups we will accumulate these top three, and then we will see and we can come out with a small write-up on this or something like this for our newsletter. We'll see how we can proceed on that. Yeah?
That anyway, last interview session, that we'll take it as an end. Guys, are you ready? Yes, you can start.
I'm not. Number one, I'm extremely happy because you are all stars. you are shining. You are only minimum 10x as compared to us, because you are indoor, probably you are more evolved than people belonging to our batch, I may call. The other observation I want to make, which is not so very happy, is I really feel sorry when I see the attractions and distractions that you are going through. Maybe your parents are caused, your mobile phone, your friends, your phone, another one things. We didn't have all this. Probably we had nothing else to use as an excuse. So probably we were ranked high. You have all the opportunities, but these tools can also be used. As long as you are using them, it's okay. The problem starts when they start using you. Nowadays I see that is what is happening. Please be very, very careful. Don't let them use you. That is most important. Secondly, reflecting on my own experience in my life, in my career, there is a certain mindset with which we became CA students. We, matlab, I speak for a few group of friends. Let me speak for myself. For me, CA was life. It is either CA or no life. That was the equation I was always faced with. I am happy that you people are not stuck like that. You are not stuck like me. If you look at it in one way, at least looking at it from my point of view, CA is a box which has allowed me not to express beyond the box. But for you people, CA is just an entry into a career. I am very happy that you are holding it at that level. We got sucked up by CA. The other things I don't want to use, we got sucked up. So I am happy for you. Please be happy for yourself. One small exercise I want to do here. All the boys, please put up your hands. Yeah, I am very clear that hands that are going to belong to boys. And just put it down. Not enough work, no problem. Girls, please put up your hand. Yeah, only one request. The boys don't look at the girls, girls don't look at the boys. You do CA very easily. If you do it very seriously, you will be called here as an actor. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Lessons that we got from Mr. Ramkumar, CA. So let me put forward some basic questions that you people would have missed out, or forgive me if you would have already got it. So the rankers, the questions goes like this. It's an open question, anyone can answer. So it's left to you people, but definitely we'll give two or three people opportunity for the same question. Of course we all know like hard work is very important. So how hard work did you people put in to get this CA final or CA rankers? Like, it's open to everyone.
You can use the podium or you can
use
the
mic.
Is it a compulsory question?
So it's open. This is a paper for them. I see 16 questions.
Paper we leave out. So it's open to anyone.
You know, it was lovely interacting with a bunch of very lively students. So, in fact, one of the questions was, is really hard work important? It was discussed even by our chief guest for the day. He was telling on the smart work. So, hard work in a smart way. So, smart hard work is what is important. You know? Definitely, hours of preparation is there, and that every day and that consistency is very important. But how do you channelize your hard work is equally important, because first know what is all that you want to prepare for, and work on your techniques of preparation and use it effectively, and then the hard work becomes smart, and I mean it pays for you, and you get you definitely will go succeeding on it. So I would say definitely, there's no doubt about that, but put it in a smart way.
So, does anyone else want to go next question?
I think one of the greatest So one of the greatest lessons that we need to realize is that there is no free lunch, right? Anything you want comes with a price, right? So if there is a destination we want to reach for now, is that qualification, definitely there is a price attached. And that price, I think, is only hard work, right? It's important for us to know the methodology, to know the direction in which those efforts need to be. But efforts are must, right? If there are a lot of us who think, right, that intelligence, I'm not very intelligent, how do I manage this? This question comes up, right? So then, just for instance, if I have to say, right, let's say, of me read 105 pages and I read 100 pages. And the question in the exam is from the 102nd page, right? Or the 102nd problem. Who do you think will be able to answer? It is Agni, not me, right? That is because she's taken that extra effort and extra hours or extra time and to cover those extra things, right? So that difference between ordinary and extraordinary is that little extra. So you can't really take out hard work at all. It is must. If there is a chair here, it is because of the efforts here. Otherwise, it was just a piece of log. So for us to reach our qualification, for now the first step is to reach that destination for getting a qualification CA. Hard work is must. There is no distinct to it at all. I think all of us will agree to it. Right?
Certainly, ma'am.
If I can summarize, it is free food available only in Radbo, nowhere else.
Very good. So let me go a little bit specific. How many hours of preparation did you people put in? How many long days, how many long nights do you people have to reach this place? Of course, this is just small specific, you've already covered how hard it is. But this specific, this many hours will definitely motivate all of us here. So who want to go?
The number of hours which I put in would not match up to yours. So I would like to say it depends on person to person. You need to understand your speed also. Some people are really fast, some people are really slow. It depends on the type of reader you are, whether you write and study, you read and study. So for me it worked out because the number of leaves we get before CA final exams is like 5 months. Some people get 6 months. Some people are getting only four and a half months. So the number of hours also would be dependent on that. But I would like to say it's the consistency which matters. So for me it was 5 months, the leaves which I got, and every day, say around, and it would depend on the month which you are in. So say for the, it was like my exams were in November. So say May, June and July I was putting almost 8 hours, 7 to 8 hours. And then towards the end it increased to 10 hours and 11 hours. So that's how it worked for me. But it might work differently for you. So you need to figure out which category you fit in.
Okay, I just want to say that the quantity of hours does not matter. The quantity of how much you have learned in those hours matters. To be very frank, I am a rank holder, but you would not believe I have never crossed 6 to 7 hours, seriously. And when I was doing articleship at that time, I had only for 2 hours, but it was consistent. From the very day, from the very first day, it was 2 hours at least, but then when I got 2 months of leave, yeah, then I increased to 3 to 4 hours, and during the last 2 months, then it was up to 6 to 7 hours, but not more than that. So, it may not work for CA finals, I know, but IPCC, I think it might work, but then again, it depends on you, as she said. If you think that you will be able to do in those many hours, 5 or 6 hours, then it is fine. But if you think you cannot do, then increase the number of hours, and it has to be done. So, that's it.
Yeah, one small word from a very senior person. The hours question is actually a trap. Very many of the students who are assembled here must be thinking, oh, you are 11 ghante odhara, you are rank bantho. Now, 5 ghante odhara, padakaga, all that is crap, I am telling you. The guy who gets to know your paper or values will have your work that you put in for 3 hours. Do your best in those 3 hours and you will get the rank. Don't worry about what hours you did, which movies you did. I keep telling my people in the office also, I say the same thing to everyone else with more force, whatever I have in my command. please stick to the best performance. I had a very close friend of mine, I did not name. He was so hard at studies, he was doing hard work. Sometime between 7 and 9 in the evening, you probably would have done smart work also, I'm not sure. But what happened, unfortunately, after 6 months of hard and smart preparation, he went to sleep in the examination. He could not control his sleep. It was physically impossibility for him to give the exam, or for the exam to take performance from him. So be very, very clear. Don't get into such high level things. Be very clear. Be true to yourself. Most important. You can easily say that I have put in my work and I didn't get the result. But are you true to yourself? Not after you get the result. Before you get the result. Before probably you go to the exam. Most important question you have to ask and answer and satisfy yourself. Result will confirm your answer. Thank you.
Certainly, sir. As you said, like, it depends on the circumstances, it depends on the person to person. You have to tailor your timing based on your... I think they were arranged for a lunch.
No, but they said you were with coffee.
Was it based on lunch? But definitely you will be served with lunch.
Free coffee was there.
Oh, yeah.
Lunch with Ranjit after this session. Please join us for lunch.
How crucial is planning during your studies? How crucial is your planning when you're studying?
So, it's always said, right, a well-planned job is half done, right? So, you need to plan in advance, and how do you plan? It needs to be detailed. You need to have a timetable in terms of when your exams are and how are you going to spread your studies across the time that is available. Now, just related to the previous question we discussed also, how many hours we need to study. So when you are planning for study, more important for us to ask is what are the topics I am planning to cover during a particular day, right? So when you are planning, it's not like you are planning for 8 hours a day or 6 hours a day. It is the number of chapters or the type of topics that you want to cover, right? So if a particular topic is going to take you this many hours, it is those many hours. Right? I might finish something faster, she might finish something else faster. So work on your strengths and plan your thing accordingly. So planning is very crucial and you need to do it well in advance. Because there is a constraint called time, only then if there is no deadline, none of us will do it. Right? So because there is a deadline, because we know that the exam is 6 months away, you will be able to plan. Right? Otherwise, none of us would even study otherwise. Right? So planning is a very important thing, and hard work with planning will pay off. Right? It will help you realize where you stand, how much time is left, and what are the topics to be covered during that time. So it will help you where you stand and how do you, you know, actually plan for the remaining time that is available.
I think I was talking about the same thing with the group with whom I was interacting. Planning is very important, but making unrealistic plans will only lower your confidence. Because if you are going to make a plan for a week and say you just think that I am going to finish this full subject in the week, and if it doesn't happen, you feel that you are lacking behind and your confidence automatically goes down, and that's not what is supposed to be happening. So that's what shouldn't be happening. Confidence is very important and you shouldn't be doing anything that is going to lower your confidence. So make realistic plans which you can achieve. How do you make a realistic plan? First you need to know how much you can do. Your friend might be able to do maybe 2-3 chapters more than you, or however it is, because each one's capacity, capability is different. But understanding the same thing and planning according to that is the most important. So please don't make unrealistic plans and lower your confidence.
Regarding planning, it is like not like audit checklist. I have made a 10 plan or 15 tick everything. Not like that. You should not get demotivated before going to exam. Suppose out of 15, you have done 60%, 70%. Don't worry. You have to go further and finish up. Instead of saying, oh, and I take all the 15, I don't want. Planning should be liberalized flexible, and according to, you know, I can give an example. Some people will read only the night, some people will read in the early morning. It's according to your comfort. And some people in a day read three subjects, two subjects. Some person will read one subject for 1 month, after that you will take up another. It depends on person to person. That you have to plan based on your capacity. Even if your 60-70% is ready, go ahead, don't worry. Write your exam, you will come out with a colorful result.
Yeah, sir. Really, as you said, planning really matters, but execution matters more than that. I plan like 16 hours a day. If I don't read for 16 hours, what's the matter in planning? So, plan, as you said, plan liberally, but you have to execute. Yesterday I was planning to read like 4 Indias. I should finish at least 4 Indias. I could finish only 3. I'm chatting with some other friend when the time is I have to read. So, sir, you have to focus on execution first. So, you can finish, you can put the target day, today I have to finish these things. At whatever the cost, whether you compromise your sleep or whatever you do, you have to finish whatever the target you have put. And if you are not finishing your target, you are not reaching the target, whatever you put it, then you are lacking behind, you are not reaching your the preparation is half cut. Every day if you say, if you sit before the books for 16 hours, I will be able to focus on 8 hours. Then what's the matter of sitting 16 hours before the books without concentration? So you have to focus the things, and also in an execution, let's say I have planned today, one day I'll finish entire consolidation in CA final. Is it possible? It's not. So it takes minimum 2 to 3 days. So that's how you have to plan based on the number of problems and the concept you have. Strategize in such a way that you should finish, like as I said, it's not 6 to 8 hours you read. I suggest you to sit before the books for how many number of hours you can, and setting everything behind. Don't put in an environment whatever you read, don't put a mobile phone or internet connection, laptop, grab that everything. Don't like everything put, like if you put a mobile phone in front of you, it attracts, take me and chat with a friend. So sit in a situation or an environment where you will be able to focus your mind. So that's what the execution matters. Thank you.
I would like to just add one point. How many of you guys actually write it in plan? Don't put it in your head. How many have a book that, you know, so far, okay. How many of you guys actually write in plan? That's a very good habit. So how it worked for me was in IPCC and CA final. I had, for each of these exams, I had one whole booklet. Like, I just got to one, it worked out. CA final, I had a real big book. You know, so planning, so what I did was, you guys also can follow it. All the 8 subjects, on first 8 pages, I wrote down the chapter names, marks next to it, and the number of pages or something of, you know, that sort, to understand how big each chapter is. So finally, like, that was the beginning of, you know, making a good timetable. And I kept on planning and rescheduling also. So after every 15 days, I would change it. I would see where I'm standing and what I need to do next. If I haven't achieved it, I'm going to take a day or 2 or something of that. I would like change the plan according to where I'm, you know, as of now. That is also very important. Keep scheduling and rescheduling to actually achieve your goals.
So just to sum up, can I say you have to plan it based on your execution capacity, and the capacity comes from your confidence. Just to sum up all the points. So the next question goes like this: how do you retain the huge syllabus? Isn't it very vast? I'm pretty sure everyone in this room will agree with this.
Yeah.
Isn't it very vast? So.
Okay, as I was speaking to my group, that how brief notes help you a lot. So there was one point of mine that this tax was the thing which troubled me a lot, because it had a 900 pages of content in it. So the thing was, what helped me is at the end, I just reduced the whole 9 pages into 200 pages long notebook, and I followed a certain color scheme, like, you know, use the 4 color pen, like red, blue, green, and your black, and then I segregated what is important, what is not. So those brief points at the end, like you're doing your hard work initially, and then it leads to your smart work at the end, because you just have 24 hours before the exam, and all you can put in is 15 hours max of complete focus, which is all you have got, how much ever you cut down. And so that leads to an advantage at the end, when your friends ask for your notes, but you give it, though you give it, it doesn't help them, because you have written it. So you have to put in initially your hard work, later it will lead on to your smart work.
One point I would like to add with respect to this is, you know, how to retain the entire content. So revisions are must. You know, always plan revisions as part of your planning. Have you heard of somebody called as Eka Sandigrahi? I was just discussing on this point. Who is called as Eka Sandigrahi? Someone who can grasp it at the first listening or first reading. How I wish. How I wish all of us would have been Eka Sandigrahi. But then, if you look at the same preparation, what you have done at the first reading, and then when you start preparing on the same thing, how comfortable you feel? That is the power of revisions. And you know, as a personal note, I never spend too much on notes making. I actually convert my text into notes. I think that's the easiest way. And there's something called as visual memory, which will help you out, because you always see, oh, I've seen this person somewhere, but I'm not getting his name. So your eyes are always far more powerful than your ears, on a general note. So, but then, how do you convert your text into notes is like, it's not at the end moment you have to do it. You should start it from your first reading itself. Mark those keywords in your textbooks, which will, because every concept will have couple of keywords which can really coin in what that concept brings for. I was just discussing on one question, like, what is meant by long-term capital gain? If this question is asked, generally people start replying on what is meant by long-term capital asset. See, question comprehension is another critical thing. If you understand the question wrongly and start answering it rightly as to what you thought is right, you will not get the score for that. So understanding the question is very important, and in taking in that definition, what is a long-term capital gain? So the gain arising from transfer of a long-term capital asset. Many people say sale. Sale is not the word. Transfer is a very comprehensive word which includes sale, relinquishment, you know, compulsory acquisition, not many things. So I only underline the word transfer, and I get a whole definition out of it. So keyword marking is one of the very important things, and we can prepare some, you know, there was a related question as well, mnemonics or some quotes which can definitely come as handy, and we should plan in such a way that how are we going to execute at the time of our revisions as well. You know, it's all about, you know, it's a comprehensive work which we actually do it. So, you know, do it accordingly, and please don't read the problems, solve them. So solving is very important, and I always feel while preparing, if we can make handy like two subjects, one theory subject coupled with the one practical subject, you know, it will give that change. And very important is, after every hour of preparation, give a 5-minute break. You know, your mind needs that break, and break for 5 minutes means only 5 minutes. So stick to that, and break should not become 1 hour, and preparation should not get to 5 minutes. And one small point I want to make, you're just doing CA, don't sacrifice everything else in your life for that. No? Plan out your weekends, enjoy that as well. That is also required, you know, that will add to your rejuvenation of your energy. Believe me, I never missed enjoying even a single weekend, so does that follow even today. So you're not doing anything, you know, wrong or something where you're very sacrificing you have to do and all that. Plan in a way that you have breaks to rejuvenate you, and also a mix and match of theory and concept, and plan for revisions that will definitely come handy. One reading plus three revisions is a must, accordingly.
I think she has proved our point that she's a ranker by answering the next question as well. I had a question for revision. No doubt she's a ranker because she understands our question so well.
I would like to add some points. So basically, as Kavi used to tell during our CPT classes, like CPT is the Earth, IPCC is the solar system, and CA panel is the universe. So you have such vast syllabus. So basically, you break it down into few points. So let's say practice manual. You have, let's take up any theory subject for example. So your theory subjects, what they are looking for is keywords basically. So you just highlight the keywords and you keep revising the keywords for that particular answer. And for practical subjects, you keep star marking all these important questions, note it down in the first page or the last page of your practice manual. So, at the time of your revision, you know this question I have to do for this particular concept. So, this will really help you for that quick revision and maybe to refer in that 1.5 days which you get between each exam. So,
and one thing for practical subjects I want to add is, for each question when we solve a problem, you will know what are the major adjustments in that. So make a note of it. For each chapter, you will have, if you have a 10 questions, first 2 pages make a note of problem, formulas, whatever you have. And then for each question, what is the adjustment, main adjustment in the question it is. And what is the solution, how you solve it. If you make a note of all this, it makes real easy to revise. It helps you a day before exam. And you will never know that you can't remember every problem in line by line. It's not easy. And if you make a note of these adjustments, and you will be able to analyze the situation for each question in independent way. And if you mix different concepts, then you will have a different answer for it. So based on the analysis, what you do, that leads you an another analysis. Like, if you, for example, you have a model 1 question in your practice and a model 2 question. If what do you do if you ask it in an exam, they mixed up model 1 and model 2 asked in an exam. So unless you analyze the situation where, how it is in the problem, you will not know how to approach for a problem. So this is the main thing which you have to do for a practical subject. And for theory subjects, as I said, you have to highlight the keywords and remember those.
I'll tell you the reason why these people are called to be rank holders, no one else. Because one person answers the next question and the next person answers the next question as well. With a single question. You know, that's how powerful this rank holders are. And let me ask the small question. How do you people incorporate this 80-20 rule? Like, did you people incorporate it? Did you people implement it when you people studied? Like, it's always said, this economist told us that 80% of your productivity comes from this 20% of your
salary.
So how do you people incorporate it? Did you people do it, or is it like without implying that it just happened to be that way? I don't care.
This 80-20 rule, it works when you want to strategize the things. But for me, I have to read everything I enter. That's what you are meant to read everything in a syllabus, isn't it?
It's like estimates, not everything.
The syllabus is so vast, I agree. But you are, as a CA, you must know what is there in the syllabus. And if you read whatever the exam perspective, you can read based on a marks weightage. For it, there are two approaches, like for an exam perspective and for a knowledge perspective. You have to mix the both. How? For when you have, let's say, 3 months of leave for an exam, prepare for exam. Read only that. Once you are finished with your exams, prepare for knowledge. And what mistake we do is, after the exam we don't read. We throw the books in a cupboard and we play matches. So, you know, after the exam, start your preparation. It helps you, let's say if you are in a final, CA final, if you start your preparation even after exam, it helps you to either, if you clear, it helps you to for interview, if you are not clear, it helps you for next exam. So it benefits in a both way. So that's what I suggest you to go for, in a two way.
Of course, we all know like we need to live the life of CA to clear CA. So how important and how from when did you people start living the life of CA to clear this or to get this ranks?
What is living the life of a CA?
Oh, it's all about like thinking the importance of CA, you know, like it just says you're a chartered accountant, just feeling the proudness of the chartered accountant.
Visualize.
So
visualize.
You can go ahead. Without, it's open.
Without a right to sign.
Yeah. Being a CA without signing. Yeah. So I don't think any of us was way too focused on the fact that we were doing our CA or anything, because you're so busy in your articleship and it's CA is one of those courses where you're actually learning from doing. So that is the difference here. And I think people say that you should be studying right from the beginning and doing your 2 hours of revision, which is not something that I was able to experience because being in a big four, the hectic nature of an articleship, and you get so involved in your articleship life that your actual studying for your CA examination, it keeps getting postponed and postponed. But I would definitely say that every single day that you go to work and you go to your articleship and you're learning over there is you being a CA. That is the thing.
Okay.
So, let it just 2 minutes. It is like this, we brought out a very important point. I won't know you by name. As to difference between knowledge and exam, I want to tell all of you very clearly, please aim for knowledge, exam will come and go. Once you miss knowledge, there is no way of clearing the exam, because without knowledge you don't get the ticket to become a professional. This is very, very important. And most people here, I know, like in sale surety at my command, I have trained maybe 100 odd people in the past 30 years. Most of the people didn't attend to first PUC, second PUC syllabus sincerely. Most important. It is no problem. Even today you can study first PUC. You should be willing. That brings your knowledge to the fore. Please concentrate.
Without knowledge, there is nothing.
And
thanks for the coffee.
One more thing I want to tell, this 80-20 rule, the one reading 100% page to page is very much required. Being the vast syllabus in final, we need to adapt 80-20 rule. Majority, what is the maximum mark chapters which covers, you have to spend your 80% of the time on those subjects. Other 20%, volume is more but marks is less. There you have to spend less time. So that if you adapt that, it will be better, you can score well. But 100% knowledge of entire subject is very much.
It's always, yeah,
definitely. Yeah, just would narrate a small incident. Everyone, I believe, has come across this TV show called Tom and Jerry. So every time in this show, Jerry wins. And Tom keeps chasing. Why does Jerry win always? Because Jerry runs for life. Tom runs for food. Food is the meat. And life is the purpose. In the same way, in our life, knowledge is the purpose, marks is the meat. So run behind knowledge, marks will keep chasing you.
With a quote of saying, knowledge is life and the marks is nothing but your purpose. So, let me ask you, what motivated you people? It's always the tough times during long days, long nights. There should be something inside you, as you always said, that there's something purpose for your life. So, what is that purpose which always kept you motivated to get this rank?
Well, for me, like, as a composite maths background student. So there, once we had a talk regarding profession, like we are all confused during that stage, like what to do next. So one person, he introduced CA. Like CA, first thing he told is money. Next thing he told is about all the knowledge you get in the variety of fields. Now for me, I myself, I just did ITCC. So in these 9 months itself, I got so much knowledge about audit, tax, everything. Like, it's actually such a dynamic course. And also, the joy of looking at the word pass and the tier. on the day of your result, like it's actually worth every second of the effort that you have put in. So CA, and also no one has taken CA from my family background, so that itself motivated me to become a chartered accountant.
So CA without CA background is motivating. Definitely, that will be motivating many
others. Same thing, even in my case, I don't have any CA in my family, so I wanted to become one. One more thing in case of for those people who have not cleared IPCC yet, after your clearance, you'll be joining articleship. What I have felt, experienced this, which I didn't know before, when you go out for audit, even though your principal is not with you, the respect that you get over there is same as a chartered accountant, which I have felt. And I actually never aimed for rank, but then I wanted to become a chartered accountant. That was a knowledgeable one, a successful one. So when you feel that, automatically you will be motivated to become one. So I just want to say.
I have a different story here about myself, kind of. I started my journey of CA after my marriage. So to all your girls out there, so marriage is never a full stop. It's as to how you take it further, and nothing is impossible, guys. Today my son is studying in 8th grade. So when I gave my CA finals, he was 4 years old, and I bagged an All India 3rd, and I didn't stop there. I took up my visa. I took up my DSA, planned for rank 1, landed at 3. Took up my CS, planned for rank 1, landed at 3. So it's always been rank 3 and me. Probably a lucky number, as he says. You know, what motivates me there is my, being a university second ranker, I always had this passion to pursue CA. But, you know, coming out from a conservative family way behind, you know, around 15 years ago, it's like we have a lovely joint family, in fact. So it was like, you get married and then do whatever you want. I took it very seriously. I'm not going to leave it. And got a very supportive husband and in-laws who supported me. But then, you have to put in what you want to put in and be strong for yourself. You know, you have multiple responsibilities, especially being girls, you have multiple responsibilities. But never stop at that. Keep your internal motivation driving and dare to dream. You know, the barrier is in your mind. I never attended any coaching classes for that matter. But what stopped me from targeting for rank 1? I hail from Chikmagalur. My whole schooling and college happened there. And I did my, you know, self-study. Why can't I compete at an all India level? Why can't I dare to dream? So always target for an exception in each subject. Why do you do mediocre plans? So have that internal motivation. Every day before I sat for my preparations, I used to visualize success before me. I used to visualize after getting qualified in like, you know, flying colors, how would my life be? How would people see me? How would be the happiness in the family? 2 minutes or 3 minutes of this visualization every day before my preparations, and that would drive me the whole day. And this is where I'm here today, and I just wanted to share this experience with you guys. Thank you.
Excellence is new normal, and your normal average is below average. So with that, let me ask one more question.
Brother, no. For this same question, it was said that any book or a television program motivated. I would like to add one thing. When I was preparing for CA final, I used to get bored and I used to read a motivation book. One friend came and dragged me to. He took out the book and said, "You should have internal motivation rather than external motivation in your book." So that made very impact on me. I stopped reading motivational books. I started aiming for the goal, whatever I wanted. So aim for the goal and put your efforts to the 100% for that. That's all. You need not have any motivator or mentor for that. You should have your own internal drive for that. That's all.
The internal drive may be external or internal, but still it has to be internally. You have to be motivated. That's what you wanted to say. And let me ask you one more question. What is the desire that you people had always? Like the desire. You know, when I was talking to one of the rank holders, he was telling me, no matter what, how much I've studied, but when I went to my LPCC exam, he told me that he has to pass it. That was his desire. So what was the desire? Can you just put it in some instances where you people had the motivations? Rather, not just motivations, it is that intensity or the desire to be there. Exam, no matter how many people walk out with the exams after 30 minutes, 40 minutes, still you had the desire, right? To sit there for 3 hours and get this rank. What was that desire in you?
I would like to say it was more of, you guys can hear me, right? I thought I was loud. Okay, but anyways, what I would like to say is I want to give my 100% wherever I am, anytime, any place. Be it, you know, whether I'm having fun also, like I'm out with my family, I'm out with my friends. I would want to give my 100% and be there, like be present. So even during the exams, when I was sitting in the hall for 3 hours, I know some questions, I don't know some questions. Whatever it is, I'm not going to leave a single second, you know, out there. I am going to give my 100%, put my best foot forward. So that worked for me.
Definitely. After rankers, tell me one thing. After writing your exams, did you people feel that you are going to be a rankers? Like, did you people feel that you are going to ace the exam? When I was talking to one of the rankers, he told me that he was not even sure that he'll pass it, but still he ranked. You know, that's where the thing is. So, how many of you felt that you are going to ace it or you are going to get the rank? So, there's one lady who has felt the same.
In fact, I was disappointed I didn't get rank one. My target was rank one, and when I got it's rank three, I said, no, I wanted one. But then, I totally enjoyed it, but then, and the difference between rank 2 and rank 3 was just one mark. That one is very close and all. But still, that wouldn't have got me to one. That gap was there. So I tried out with DSA and CS, somehow, always 3, then I stopped.
Still, now you are sitting with many rank holders, so it doesn't matter with the one mark. Still, you are on the same diet. How many of you, of course you people have very good communication skills, but how important is public communication skills after you people pass your CA finals or your entrance? So how important do you feel that? Because of course we all come from different backgrounds, many people here from different tier 2, tier 3 cities, and we all don't have very good communication skills, but how important did you people feel it, and did you people had the urge to inculcate it? Or did you people have the urge to make the changes in yourself?
I think till the time we see our results, till the time we clear our results, the thing bothering us is whether we are going to pass, are we going to pass? That is the question. But the moment you pass, the biggest question is what next? Right? And there are ample amount of opportunities and there is a lot of competition as well. Right? So for you to stand out, it's important that you present yourself in a way better than what you actually are. Right? A lot of times people do say that, you know, getting through the job interview is more difficult than doing the job itself. Right? So to meet the competitive this thing and for you to come out of it successfully, it's very important. So whenever you're taking up orientation, GMCS, don't take it lightly. Right? It's fun being part of that program and make sure you get the most of it. Right? The network there and then the kind of context you build, that is also very important, because post-qualification you need some guidance on what you want to do next, how is it going to be, and it's always good to get a lot of perspectives, right? A lot of people are, like, even in my family, I'm the only CA, right? So when I pass, in the family circle, there's nobody to actually guide you. So you need to know a lot of people, right? So you have to start building those contacts. And for that, you need to really be able to break the ties and start communicating, right? It's also said, fake it till you make it. It's okay. You know, if you're not able to really do well or speak well, or you know, communicate well, don't stop at that, right? It's okay for you to think that you are doing well and fake it till you make it. Till the time you're going to ace it or excel it, keep doing it thinking you're going to excel it. So it's like very important,
And it's not a one-time activity that you learn communication and then it's done, right? It's a daily process. So when you're going to client places, start interacting with people. When you're working, especially when you come to industry after qualification, there are a lot of teams which are working in a company, right? So you don't restrict yourself to the finance process itself. Start interacting with the business, start talking to people, you know, start having lunch with different sets of people. Try to break that ice and make contact. It's very important.
I thought I have to put this point on public speaking very clearly. I would rather say you people are very lucky. There is something called GMCS. We never had. We toiled 30 years to reach where I am speaking today. I think half of the people can do a much better job than me today, because you have been through some courses on public speaking and communication skills which we never did. It was not available to us. Plain simple vanilla truth, but the medium has to be used by you. Only one final say I want to say here. We are all very well bent on our mindset. Most important thing for a human being to click in life, in any area, be it CA, BA, DA, doesn't make much difference. You tend to believe that you ishchana madhya omitam matarvatapa agalanan kalnadutthayade. So we feel, once you get this feeling, oh my legs are giving way, you are not supposed to go on speaking. Do you know Manmohan Singh, Modi, everybody is undergoing the same fever, and that's why man invented the podium. Don't worry, let the others bother about their hands or leg shiverings. Do your best, okay?
Come out of this fear, we have a speaker's talk. We'll meet every Sunday between 8 to 10 or 11. Whoever interested, you can join. You can meet our Sikasa student. After this meeting, you can join that Sikasa forum.
So I'd like to just add one more point. Right now we don't understand how important this communication skills is. You know, you're taking team skills, orientation, going for IT, but you take it, okay, we need a certificate and that's why we're going. You don't understand what happens post you qualify. So, such good chartered accountants, how much knowledge they have. What happens in a GE? When you, how many of you want to take up a job post you qualify CA? It's a good thing, so what happens in job interviews is, say 50 people are coming. Out of that, I would give my example. I went for Aditya Birla Group for the job interview, and there were 50 rank holders which we are talking about. Okay, and they are all flown from different parts of the country to give this interview. Post the first round, most of these places would be your group discussion. So however good you are, how much ever knowledge you have, even rank 1, 2, 3, they are, you know, not being selected post the GE. Can you imagine what a situation it might be? Because you're talking about, you know, putting, you know, your thoughts out there. So it's very important to be really good when you're talking to people, and those group discussions are going to make a lot of difference. So when we have those GEs in our GMCS, it's going to help you and take full use of it. Like, ensure that you are, you know, coming out and speaking up. Because if you can't do that, then you don't get to the GEs and that job is gone. So out of that, there's like 10 people. I mean, can you imagine the ratio? Like, such good rankers and everyone's really good with their knowledge, but what's the point? You can't talk. So take it seriously.
One more thing, all good communicators are not rankers. Or look at it the other way, all rank holders will not be good communicators. So you have a great chance.
And of course there is one voluntary platform as well, which you can, as Srinivasa sir introduced, there is one more platform where you can improve your communication skills, not just your orientations or GMCS, so that can definitely help. And with this, let me conclude by saying this. No matter how many stars has been produced like this in ICI, there is always this one pole star or this northern star. No matter what, it always shines bright as ever. So there's this person who is nothing but our chief guest, who is none other than our chief guest, CA Pattabhiram, who always there to guide us. No matter what, he is always standing like a north pole and always guided us. So let me ask Pattabhiram sir to just give a closing remark with all the inputs that he has got.
I think we heard some really outstanding ideas there. My closing remark is just to check whether you heard what I spoke in the morning. So can you tell me what was the first alphabet? power of the process. I again tell you, it's the power of the process. What was the second? Sorry? So you asked them a lot of questions or you didn't ask them? You asked. So you implemented what I told you. What was the third one?
Practice.
Which is what came from what many of them said that about the hard work being important. What was the S? Task study. And what was the last one? Wonderful. So if you remember all that, I think my job here has been absolutely well done. Second importantly, I just wanted to make one point. I didn't pick the idea very correctly, but if somewhere down the line you got a message at some point in time that a role model is not important in your life, that you can do everything on your own, please know that. You need to have a role model in life at every stage, because you need to look up to somebody whom you would like to emulate and do better than that. I think we are close to 145. My teacher in college always used to say that when people are hungry, they become angry. So I don't want to take more of your time. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone in the dais for this interactive session.
I just want to ask you a question, right? How do we actually look for role models, right? When we are studying, right, we look at our teachers. But post that, at workplace, it's really difficult to find somebody that inspirational whom we can actually get involved
with. Well, that's a fair question, but I think in every organization there will be someone. In a company there will be someone. There will be a role model, need not be very senior. A role model can be a young achiever. He can be just 28 years old and he might have risen very fast. He need not be a CA. He could be a graduate from the Indian Institute of Management. I know it's not very politically correct to talk about IIM at the ICI Institute, but I always held them in extremely high regard, because my first boss when I first worked was an IIM graduate. And those guys are absolutely top class. They're absolutely top class. They might have their sense of vanity and all that, but you need to pick up the right skills from them. So the person, the role model can come from anywhere. No, I think somewhere today people were talking about the importance of planning. If you look at Mahendra Singh Dhoni, for example, I have never seen a guy who is as Bindas as him. He does not plan, he does not have team meetings, he is never flustered. Someone can even look at him as a role model. He is the complete opposite of Virat Kohli. The fact that both of them have been successful is a point that people can follow different routes to success. Now, between them, for example, the one whom you admire, you can follow that. So you always find a role model if you're hunting for one. And most often in good organizations, right? If yours is a company which has 1,000 employees, I'm sure you will find somebody there.
Thank you, sir, for the inputs on role model. I would like to take this moment to thank CA Annapurna Ma'am with a memento. I would ask Sikasa Chairman, CA Srinivas sir, to present the memento.
Maybe our rankers, they have given much of their time. She is going for another conference on bank branch audit. That's why she has to leave early. Your honorary with our momentum.
Sorry about that, I couldn't stay back. So I wish all each one of you all the very best for your future endeavors. So I wish you all the best. Thank you.
I now call upon Mithun to give the word of thanks.
Good afternoon, everyone. Before we wind up, I would like to take 10 minutes to give a formal vote of thanks. And I hope every one of you have made the best use of today's rankers meet. I mean, I think all of us are inspired by the rank holders.
I request students to wait for 2 more minutes till concluding. That is my request.
Yes, the lunch is getting ready at 2 o'clock, so please be seated. Yeah. On behalf of the Sikasa Bangalore, I would first like to thank our chief guest for the day, CA Pattabhi Ram, who has told us the Pepsi way for our success. Thank you. Thanks for your presence, sir. I would like to ask C.A. Srinivas, sir, SIGASA chairman, to present the memento to Pattabhiram, sir. I'd also like to thank C.A. Ramkumar, sir, who has been with us and who has given his valuable time and inspired all of us here.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And now I would like to thank all the rank holders, C.A. Shobha Suresh, C.A. Avni Mehta, C.A. Annapurna Srikanth, C.A. Priya K., C.A. Atul Agarwal, C.A. Balakrishna Chiliveri, Ms. Aradhana Upadhyay, Mr. Deepak Acharya and Ms. Prabhavi and Mr. Kamal M. Rolia for interacting with us. I would like to ask C.A. Chairperson of Bangalore branch of SIRC of ICA, C.A. Shravan sir, to present memento to rank holders. Yeah, C.A. Shobha Suresh. C.A. Balakrishna Chiliveri. C.A. Avni Mehta. Thank you, sir. Now I would like to ask Ranjit to present mementos to other rank holders. C.A. Priya K. Ms. Aradhana Upadhyay.
Of course, we provide breakfast there.
And last but not the least, I'd like to thank all the staff of Bangalore branch of ICA, and I'd like to thank all the budding rank holders who have come here and made this event a grand success. Thank you, Anand. And we are ready for lunch. You can have a lunch in the canopy. Thank you.
I would request all of you to give a standing ovation to the dignitaries on the earth.